Good evening, and may I wish you a very happy new year from here in Newcastle. And as they say up here, all the best to you and yourn for the coming 12 months. Well, of course, New Year and Christmas is a time for reflection, celebration, and for snogging with strangers. It's also a time for unusual and dark stories. It was here in Studio 5 of Time Tees Television where we made the popular exotic music and educational programme, The Tube. We made 123 programmes totalling 202 hours. It was unquestionably the leading show of its time. At first, it was easy enough. I would open the show with, good evening, it's Friday, it's 5:30 and the pubs are open. Then we'd have perhaps a little bit of nudie dancing, then maybe a filmed item on hairdressers or scooters or something like this. Then there would be three live bands playing. And then I'd be carried back to my dressing room to prepare myself for the following week's show. It was all so easy until one morning I looked in the mirror and became terrified by what I saw. I started to grow a large gold medallion here on my chest. My hair was beginning to get big. The number plate on my Lotus 7 car had become personalised. In short, I was becoming a celebrity. I couldn't believe this horrible malaise that I'd seen happen to so many others in my profession was now happening to me. I was planning to move to Hollywood or maybe Marbella. My closest friends were all professional golfers or newsreaders. I had even done performances for charity. I had become a prisoner in a cage of my own making. I decided to resign. I had admired the way that Patrick McGoohan had done it in his 1967 series, The Prisoner. He was set to be James Bond, but somehow he'd escaped. He seemed more interested in questions than he did in answers. I, perhaps foolishly, decided to try and follow in his footsteps. Remember then, the only thing that keeps us prisoner is our own imagination, or lack of cash, or being a convicted criminal. So let's now turn back the hands of the clock, back to when this was a welcoming and warm open passage, when enough was enough and my hair was becoming just a little bit too big for my boots. I've been mistreated on this program and I've had enough. And I think, people at home, if you've had enough of something, you just get out.
Television's upstairs, they won't be happy.
I don't care about televisions upstairs, I'm going, I've had enough.
No, please come back. Got cash.
I don't want cash, I've had enough.
We've all had a whip round.
The viewers would appreciate it. I've had a lot of problems in this program.
Quid.
I've not been treated as well as I might have done. I don't want your money, just go away. I've had enough. I've had enough. I don't want to talk it over. I've had enough. I'm off. I'm going. Good boy.
Come back, please.
No. No. Not in a back room, is it?
Please.
No.
Nothing to do to save his life, call his wife in. Nothing to say, but what a day. How's your boy been? Nothing to do, it's up to you. I've got nothing to say, but it's okay. Good morning, good morning, good morning.
A still tongue makes a happy life.
How did you get in?
Questions are a burden to others. Answers a prison for oneself.
Get out!
What is this place? Where am I?
Oh, here's the village hose. Hooray. Why, I've got a very port load of surgery. Excuse me.
That's a throw. I'm not far upon. I'm not free from my
wall. Oh, yeah. You, number seven. Yes, you, number seven. Up here.
Oh, I'm not a number. I'm a television personality.
Oh, very good, number seven. Now, come up here. Join me for something to eat.
Number seven, thank you so much for coming out. Do sit down.
Look, what is this place? Who are you?
I am number two, and this is the village. Get to know it well, number seven. From now on, it's your home. It's your home until you give us certain information that we require from you.
Well, I'm perfectly happy to tell you anything you would like to know. What would you like to know?
Don't play games with me, number seven. I'm not very good at them. By hook or by crook, by fair means or foul, we will find out why you resign.
Well, it's perfectly simple. For a long
I begin to weary of your impertinent tricks, number seven. Let me tell you something about this installation. 20 years ago, this village was founded for the simple purpose of extracting information from certain showbiz personalities who had inexplicably resigned their posts. Now, after all these years, only 3 people remain. Let me tell you something about them. First, there is number six. There he is. He's a man full of spunk. Mark him well, number seven. He labors under the pathetic delusion that he is an individual. We, however, know better, and we will break him. Believe me, we will break him in the end, however long it takes, just as we will break you. 20 years ago, he resigned from a highly successful television series, Danger Man.
Right.
Since then, he has been here, a prisoner of this village, and nobody can understand why. Earth he's doing here. And then we have prisoner number three. Blisteringly insane. I believe you've already met him. No one can comprehend a single syllable that he utters. But in the end, we'll find out what we need to know from him. We'll understand him. And then there's you, number seven. 1 week ago,
you mysteriously walked out of one of the most popular child exploitation programs on television. Why?
Well, it's really simple.
Still, that's enough of business, Number Seven. I think it's time you got to know our little village here. Let me give you some clothes that are more appropriate for our setting.
Thank you very much.
And a blazer. 400 work units.
Oh.
Valid at any branch of Peter Jones or John Lewis. And a map of your village.
Oh.
Relax, Number Seven. Get to know the place. The more you toe the line, the more fun you'll have.
Right. Well, thank you very much.
Be seeing you.
Be seeing you, yes.
Oh! And Number Seven, be careful. Oh. Be very, very careful.
Righto, then I shall, yes. Thank you.
Self-check made impossible. Let me see, how resolve it for? Night jumping, how tricky, how crookie, yes, through. K queen through form, and bishop out, Laurie's that folly. Too talk us over there. So if the white out of the check mold.
Number seven.
Self-check.
Brown.
What's your hair colour?
Size 12.
Why did you resign?
Well, for a long time I've got.
No, you're not falling for that one, are you? You're too wise for that. I'll get you out sometime. I want you to be more cheerful, though. I want you to enjoy life here. Not like number six, I'm so morose. Let me introduce you to Rover here. He's a splendid fellow. Now, Fetch boy, Fetch!
Or me?
No, no, Rover. Go on, boy. Go on, go on. I'm getting old and fat now, of course. Come on, boy. Come on, come on. He used to be very vicious, of course, in the 60s when we had lots of prisoners here. Now he's, he just takes sudden dislikes to people. I think he won't to you. He's a bit like number six. But if you throw yourself into village life, he won't harm you. I want you to watch our entertainments, like young Susie here.
And high.
Hello? Who do you want? Number six?
Number six?
No, I'm afraid this is number seven here. You've got the wrong number. I'm sorry.
What do you want?
Number six?
I said, what do you want?
You are number six?
That is the number of this place.
Call from number two.
Ah, number six. How do you feel about a spot dinner? Hmm?
I'd like to mind my own business.
Oh, tush now, number six. Don't be stroppy. See you in half an hour.
The mountain can come to Muhammad.
Ah, number seven.
Now, how do you feel about a spot of dinner?
That'd be lovely.
Meet me below the Gate of Humility, just south the portico of Earthly Delight. I shall see you there in,
half an hour?
I see.
Black tie.
Full dress. Okay.
Excellent. Be seeing you.
Ah, number seven. So happy you could join us. And you, Rover, that's your seat over there. Good boy. As you, number six, are bothered to show up to the rebellious, childish adolescent at you, I'm afraid. Nonetheless, we're here to enjoy ourselves, so tuck in one, tuck in all. Tuck in three, tuck in seven.
The black hole. This gives you the black hole of the distance through, which light years of Alpha Centauri, which is the speed of...
I do think number six might have turned up. He just doesn't enjoy it here.
Can't think why. I think it's absolutely idyllic. I really do. It's one of the most lovely places I've ever been. Thanks for bringing me here.
Oh, yes, indeed. So I think we'll settle for that and as joyful.
What a strangely repellent man you are, number seven.
Well, you say that, number two, but I feel as though you should...
Excuse me a moment. Yes, number two.
Orange alert. Orange alert.
I see. Thank you. Seems there's an orange alert. Quick, you'd better put these on. You've worn them before?
No.
Quick, after it! After him! Just stand there, you big mimsy hen. Get after it! Go on, grab it! Oh!
I see. So he's totally expendable. Thank you. Now, number seven, let me just adjust these electrodes here.
This isn't going to hurt at all, is it?
Oh, my dear fellow, you must trust me. Of course it's going to hurt. It's going to hurt dreadfully. Awful pain. Now, what we want is to have you nice and relaxed so we can unlock the inmost secrets of your inmost heart.
This once-a-polytito is called Goldilocks. Three bear loaders lived in the deep forest. Happy. But a little family normal, if you understand me.
You see, number three is going to read from one of his stories.
A little squabble between mum and dad. If so,
I want you now
out of bed in the
deep,
early morning.
Oh, deep Molly. Into the heart of the
past.
You'll find that your eyes grow very heavy. And all you can hear is my voice and the voice of the inexpressibly bowel-shatteringly tedious number three and his rolling off.
Then there were the chairs. I mean,
so you become totally
at the end of the tabloid.
Quite relaxed. Connect the dream reader now. I don't care how dangerous it is, more power. More! All right, that's enough. Disconnect the dream reader. Can't take any more. Really, number... Yes, all right, number three, keep quiet. Really. Someone would throw a green baize cloth over that creature. My God, you're an egomaniacal bastard, aren't you, number seven? You're just obsessed with yourself. I thought number six was egomaniacal, but you beat him by a long head, and he's been here a long time. He's known more number twos than the gentleman's lavatory of Waterloo Station.
You're going to stay here a long time unless you mend your ideas.
Citizens, may I first say how gratified I am to see that you have all turned up, including you, number six. Yes, I can see you. Don't dawdle at the back, man. Come forward. Really, I do wish you'd take a little bit more interest in the proceedings of the village, number six. Thank you. Now, I have gathered you here to make an announcement. An announcement of a marvelous new competition. A photography competition, ladies and gentlemen. Open to all members of the village. And the first prize is your freedom. Now, are there any questions?
What sort of subject should we be taking photographs of?
Intelligent question, number seven, thank you. I shall, of course, only be accepting works whose subject is one of incomparable beauty. I might add, by way of a hint, that I'm better full face than in profile. Now, shoot away!
the village photographic competition is number 3.
Your prize number 3 is your freedom. You must be out of the village tonight. I never want to see you again.
Well, now, number 3, you won't be needing this anymore. You're a free man now, not a number. Oh, I shall miss you. You must be our oldest resident. 45 years, is it? Oh, that reminds me. You came to us with some money. £5, I think it was. There you are. I think you'll find that's good anywhere. And your clothes, too. Very smart. Very 1987. Very street. So, off you go, then. What do you think you'll be doing now,
I'm going to liaison with number 1 through Foreman Fido. These are the dyes which Hitler was called through. Abney Capers of Edward the Acre, and Wallace Wharton Simsole. For all this publicity, put down my diaries. Oh, yes, from the middle 30 Fido. All these.
Christ, I'm going to miss you, number 3.
Well, it's really nice to have seen you, number 3. Thanks
good
a lot.
Goodly, bye, Laurie.
Good luck in the big world.
Yes, farewell. You see, it's so simple, number 7. So childishly easy. So straightforward. All you have to do to walk out of here a free man is to tell me why you resigned. Why did you resign, number 7?
Well, for a long time, I'd been getting...
Oh, there's a band. Would you like to introduce them? The village concert.
Okay, then. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome a super, really groovy rock and roll group. We give you Magnum.
Shadows pounding out the beat where the old man gets brain and the children try to sleep. Just another promise, they don't really care, cause the movement of the borders got the people running scared. Front door open, you'd be the foolish one.
There we have it, then, a fabulous metallic sound from Magnum with Vigilante Man. Let's have a big hand for Magnum, shall we?
You see, number seven, you haven't really resigned at all. You're still the same word-tripping, faintly incompetent, fluffy little pop presenter you always were. Now, why don't you take the opportunity to walk from here a free man? All you have to do is to tell me, why did you walk out last week?
Why?
I'll tell you on one condition, and that is that I can meet number one.
Very well. But I advise you to put these on first. And number seven, don't say I didn't warn you.
Oh, it's not number one after all, is it? The mirror.
Oh,
I don't know how they got there. Oh, well, number one isn't here, but for goodness sake, tell me why you resigned anyway.
Well, it's perfectly simple, you see. Can I interrupt you and just let me explain something for a moment? This whole fantasy, this whole conundrum is finished, you see. The reason that I resigned, the reason I walked out, is for months and many years I hadn't had a holiday for a long time, and I think everybody deserves a holiday, don't you?
My dear fellow.
Well, I've had it now, and so I feel as though I can return to my normal duty as a pop television presenter. So, the illusion is shattered and the bubble has finally burst. I've been away for a week. I've enjoyed it very much. We've had a bit of fantasy, and I think it's interesting that we've managed to address issues such as fear of freedom, individuality, not something you often see on the tube. Are there any questions, for instance, that anybody would have? Has anybody got any questions?
Yes. When we started...
Yes.
You were packing a gun all day.
Yeah.
And you put your passport in the drawer. Well, any fool knows, when you go on all day, you need your passport. I think that was a deliberate...
Wrong again. Because I was, in fact, going on my holidays to here, Port Merriam. Port Merriam is in North Wales, and although the people of Wales speak a different language, eat many different foods, and are of a, indeed, a different culture, you do not need a passport to come here. So I'd recommend it for any holiday plans you have. Seeing you.
Very long time.
Yes. Now you've returned, I suppose you're expected to get your old job back.
Probably want your old job back.
Yes,
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 indeed. Well, I'm afraid you must realise that in your absence there have been a great many changes at Channel 4.
A lot of changes.
A lot of changes. And, in fact, your job as such no longer exists.
It simply isn't there.
No. So, I suppose we shall have to try and do something for you. And in that case, I have asked my son here, my assistant controller here, to draw up a list of jobs that are still vacant.
Shall I read them out?
Please do.
Right, please. Linking spots on TVAM, Tuesday mornings. Pre-match interviews for the Allied Provincial Volleyball Tournament. Celebrity birthday roundup, 6:30 Sunday mornings. Or there's the epilogue.
And of course, all at a greatly reduced fee.
Greatly reduced fee. Yeah. So, where do we stand?
Thank you.
What do you want?